Well, Andy, the pluckers, I've sore finger again with you. Thanks indeed for joining me for what should be a bit of an interesting guitar lesson for you. It's a request I've had in for a song from Emerson, Lake and Palmer, and the song's called From the Beginning, okay? I will put a link in the description box which takes you to a live performance of the song by Greg Lake, and this is the version that I'm basing my lesson on, okay? So I'm in standard tuning, no capos, and I'm doing it in the same key as Greg Lake, okay? So without more ado, I'm going to go through the song now and cover all the relative parts that you need, and then I'll break it down and show you how I played it, and you should be good to go. Okay, so here we go. Might have been things I missed, but I don't be unkind. It don't mean I'm blind. Perhaps there's a thing or two I think I might have made you shouldn't have said. It's all clear. You were meant to be here. In the beginning, yeah. In the beginning, and so on. Okay, so that's the basics of the song, I think. Okay, so we'll start with the intro. It's a good place to start. Basically harmonic on the 12th fret, 6th string and the top 3 strings, 1, 2 and 3, okay, so very lightly placing my 3rd finger across the, directly over the 12th fret, and lightly, just very lightly pressing on the strings, just resting on the strings really, hit the 6th string, take finger off, and the same with the top 3 strings, 1, 2 and 3. Okay. Then playing the 10th fret of the 1st string, 12th fret of the 1st string, then 12th fret of the 2nd string. Okay, so. Right, then playing the 10th on the 10th fret of the 2nd string. And then we're doing a bend on the 12th fret of the 2nd string, up and down. And then ending up on the 9th fret of the 3rd string. Okay, so that so far is. Got that, slowly. Okay, then we do 2 hits on that surf. 9th fret of the 3rd string, and then hammer up to the 11th fret of that 3rd string, so it's, and then move, slide it up to the 12th fret, so it's, okay, sorry, bum bum dum bum, got that, so far. Then we play this chord, I think it's A minor 9th or something. Basically fretting the 10th fret of the 4th string and 12th fret of the 3rd string, open 5th string, open 2nd string, open 1st string, okay? And you just arpeggiate down from 5 down to 1. Okay? So that's the first half of the intro, so okay, that's that. Then we go into this shape. Basically, first finger is playing the 10th fret of the second string, and my second finger is playing the 11th fret of the third string. Fourth string is open, first string is open, okay, and you just arpeggiate from 4, 3, 2, 1, back to 2, back to 3, and then repeat. So you use it, so it's two lots, okay. Then we turn that sort of shape upside down and we put the first finger on the 10th fret of the 3rd string and second finger on the 11th fret of the 2nd string, and we repeat the process. 4, open 4th, open 1st, down 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, twice. Okay, so far. Finally, we take this shape all the way back down to the 5th fret and the 6th fret. So, third string on the 5th fret, and the 2nd string is on the 6th fret. Open 4th, open 1st. Again, same picking pattern. 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3. And so, and then you slow it down, and you end up with a sort of strum or whatever you want to do. Okay, so the whole intro. Okay, and we come to this bit. And this is a bend on the 2nd fret of the 6th string. Bend it, hit the 4th string. And then you bend it again, 6th string. So it's bend, 6th string, hit the 4th string, bend, 6th string, hit the 5th string. Okay? Okay? And that bend is quite... If you play it too slowly, it's quite easy to go out of tune with it, too sharp or too flat. So it's practice makes perfect on that. You can go way out of tune with it quite easily. So I tend to just keep it fairly brisk, shall I say. So there's less chance of going out of tune with it, okay? So, from the beginning. And then it goes in, after it does that bend, hit the open A string, and then you go into this A minor ninth shape again that you played earlier in the intro. 10th on the 4th, 12th on the 3rd, open 5th string, open 2nd string, open 3rd, 1st string. Then we go down to this chord. Again, open 5th string. And 4th fret of the 4th string, open 3rd string, 3rd fret of the 2nd string, 3rd fret of the 2nd string, open 1st string. So the 3rd string, 1st string, 3rd string, and the 5th string are open. 4th on the 4th, and 3rd on the 2nd, okay? And apparently that's a D sus 4 plus 9 or something. Okay, so you've got that. Do two of that before the singing starts. Okay, so from the beginning. whilst you're doing those chords, A minor ninth and D suspended fourth and ninth, whatever it is, try not to hit the sixth string. Okay, and some people I've noticed can do actually try and mute it by resting a finger on it and trying to kill it. I just try to be a bit more accurate with my strumming, five down to one. Okay. Anyway, so that's into the song. So two lots of those chords. Hit the fifth string. Hit the fifth string. All right, now the singing starts. There might be some things I missed. Then we go into this rundown. And it's basically a C chord. And you hit the third on the fifth string. So basically a third on the fifth. Third open. And then I tend to strum the last two, three strings. Something like that. And then partial G chord. Second on the fifth. Third on the second, and again that sort of thing. Okay, make sure you emphasize those notes. Okay, then we go into an F ninth, so it's a basic F shape with little pinky added onto the third fret of the first string, and it's arpeggiated. Okay, so it's something like that, okay? So 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? That sort of thing. So far, after it comes out of the bendy bit, so it goes two lots of this before singing. Now the singing starts, okay? There might have been things I missed, but then we move the F shape up two frets to make it a G shape, a G chord, same F shape with the G chord, third fret. And again, same sort of picking, that sort of thing, okay? So after that, so, and then up to G. I don't mean I'm blind. Then we go into an F or a D minor seventh chord actually. It's a D chord shape, but played on the 5th fret and the 6th fret. So just move it up 3 frets and open 4th string. Okay, so 5th fret, 3rd string, 5th fret, 1st string, 6th fret, 2nd string, open 4th string. It's a D minor 7th, I think. Okay. So from that bendy bit, two lots of this. Singing songs. There might have been things I missed, but don't be unkind. G, don't mean F or D minor 7th, fine. And then we do another. So it does talk two rounds on that. And then finish on that first string, the second time round, and then another bendy bit, same as it was before, and back up to these two chords again, and the second verse comes straight in on that one. Perhaps there's a thing or two. Okay, so I'll just go from that. So there's that, there's a thing or two, and then back into the C, to the partial G, to the F ninth, to the G, to the D minor seventh, and then it goes again, and then another two lots of these two chords. Okay, so let's just get to that point, and then we're going into the bridge section. Okay, so from the very intro, let's go from the intro. Okay. Thank you. might have been things I missed, but don't be unkind. Don't mean I'm blind. Perhaps there's a thing or two I think of lying in bed I shouldn't have said. But there it is, two lots of this. You see it, now we go into the middle section or the bridge section. So have the second lot of this to chord, you end up with that chord. You see it, and then we go to this D minor seventh again. Then we go to the G shape. The F shape but the G position, but we add the little pinky again, G ninth, to the first fifth fret of the first string, and we go. So that's all with the pinky on the fifth fret of the first string. You arpeggiate down, take pinky off, play the first string again, second string, third string. Okay. So. After it comes out of the, after it comes out of the bendy bit, two lots of this, you come into this, you see it's all clear. Here you were, back to the D minor seventh, meant to be here. This chord comes in there on here. Right, and that's a E7 flat 9th suspended 4th, apparently. Okay, so what we've got there is basically open 6th string, 2nd on the 5th, 3rd on the 4th, 2nd on the 3rd, and 3rd on the 2nd, and the 1st string is open. So 6th string and 1st string open, and then 2nd on the 5th, 3rd on the 4th, 2nd on the 3rd, and 3rd on the 2nd. It's a diminished shape, but in the middle 4 strings. And you play all 6 strings, just arpeggiated. And if you want to get something like the record, you can, after you've gone through that chord, you can do that little trill, hit the open string, 1st string, and then trill that first fret on and off on the first string. Okay, and then it goes, and then it goes into the bendy bit again. In the beginning, and then it goes off into the next verse basically, and just repeats the whole thing. Okay, and then there's a bit of an instrumental. Piano solo, synth solo, what have you, okay? But that's the basic song, okay? So we'll go through the whole thing up to that point, okay? And then you've got everything you need to play the song, I think. Okay, so here we go. I'll try and play it as slowly as I can without losing the thread, okay? Things I missed, but don't be unkind, it don't mean I'm blind. Perhaps there's a thing or two I think of lying in bed I shouldn't have said, but there it is. It's all here. You were meant to be. Here. hopefully that'll sort you out and you'll be able to make some sense of that and enjoy playing that song. Thank you very much for watching and listening. Any problems, let me know, but hopefully that will suffice. See you later on the next video. Bye for now.